Alright, we're back.
We're
at
back.
The mouth of the Cave of Many Questions.
There is
inside,
question.
You can see thousands and thousands of little pieces of paper with, like, the characters of questions that have been, like, gummed to the walls and the ceiling and parts of the floor. Just leading in. It's almost like Scylla, right? Like there's a slight breeze and they all rustle. And I think there is a trickle of of water just running down the floor, slowly cutting
its way. And
it's like carrying
like iron residue, so it's
yeah.
dead.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
What do?
I would like to sort of stand in the kind of mouth of the cave and cast my eyes around, and like I think while the other two were sort of having that discussion about the like scars of the mountain, I'm sort of like standing in the mouth of the cave and listening carefully and looking around, sort of seeing whether the cave like goes back a long way, and just trying to get a feel for like what kind of danger is in here and that sort of thing. So.
Yeah. Cool.
I think at this point, Hesb's like grabbed your shoulder. I'm like, Mal, I'm totally lacking on character names again. Tialia's like shoulder, and like is like holding her still, and is like, hang on, I just got to check this. And is like poking and like gently like pushes the wound. And is like, do you feel any tenderness? You gonna be alright?
No,
it feels
better than it did before.
Yeah, and I think this is the point at which and this is the point at which he like peels off the moss, and even though it's only been like what, Ash, like an hour, maybe two, the moss has gone like it's completely dead. It's like it's completely dead, and it
like
peels
as you do
away.
It turns to like chalk.
It just turns into dust in my hand, and there's just like no wound, just this tiny little mushroom growing out of your skin. And it's like this, it's the same like weird black mushroom, and I just reach in and like pluck it out.
Oh, that's nasty.
And like it's not in there, it's just on.
Yeah.
And I just like pull it off and then like brush the last of the residue away.
Cool.
And then just like look at the mushroom mournfully and then pop it in my mouth.
I knew you were gonna do that.
Yeah.
I'd love to roll Discern Realities, Ash.
Yeah, go for it.
Discern those realities, Emily.
I'm gonna do that. Oh, yeah!
Fuck yeah!
Yeah.
You are the discerning most of all the realities.
I discern everything. Fantastic.
Also, everyone, don't forget to mark that XP when you fail.
Yeah, I just had that thought.
Even
right.
though
I failed
almost
a lot.
Certainly won't level up, but that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
It's the spirit of the thing.
I always feel for one-shots, the aim is to level up at the end of the game.
Yeah
exactly. That's how you win. Right? Like,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You're still alive and you level up.
Okay, I have questions.
Yeah.
What happened here recently? What is about to happen? And what here is not what it appears to be?
Cool.
So, I think...
I am about to step inside.
That's
about
to happen. I think you hear a rumbling. It's almost like a purr, right? But deeper.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes and goes like breath. And it's from deep inside this cave, as if it's bouncing around a lot. So there's probably like at least one like big bend or something further down the cave.
Mm-hmm.
And that is, like, that is unchanged. It's been there. You're just picking it up now.
Okay.
That's...
So is that...
What's happened
here
recently?
Recently.
Something
like, is maybe sleeping or resting or...
Yeah, this space has been peaceful until right now. Until you arrived.
Until you
so
made
the answer
the
is kind of
charged.
So kind of the answer is, like, not much has happened here recently.
Yeah.
It has been calm. Cool.
Yeah.
Good to know.
Our arrival has happened here recently.
Yeah.
Very exciting.
Yeah.
Yep. As far as like what is about to happen, I think you notice, I think you spot that this water that's running along the bottom of the cave is deceptive, in that it like masks its own depth, and it and also some of, and also like all of the area around it will be quite slippery.
Okay.
It's actually the floor of this cave is much more treacherous than it appears.
Is that what here is not what it appears to be, or
no? That's I think that's what is about to happen.
Well,
because your friend is about to step
into
that water.
Step into the cave. Yeah. Okay, and the water is deeper than it looks and really slippery.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. What here is not what it appears to be.
What here is not what it appears to be. The questions.
Okay.
You take some time to like read them, and they're the strangest questions.
Mm.
They're all things like, "Does my husband really love me?" Or like, and things like this, and you realize that they're all questions that a person wouldn't actually want to know the answer to.
Right, as in questions that they would know. They wouldn't want to know the answer to.
Yeah, kind of. Well, no, they're all questions that I think that people think they want to know the answers to, but they don't.
Okay.
They never have a good answer.
But that doesn't seem unexpected. Like that is what I know of this cave. Is that you ask questions and then you get unpleasant answers.
But these questions haven't been answered.
Okay, how do I know that? Like what evidence do I have that tells me that?
I think there would be a ritual here, right? Like, if there were an answer to it, it wouldn't be on the wall.
Okay. Right, so they're all questions that would have unpleasant answers, and they appear to be as yet unanswered.
Yep.
Hmm.
And further, the further into the cave, the sparser mm-hmm. they get.
The what, sorry? The sparser they get?
Yep.
Okay.
Do the type of questions change?
The further into the cave, the more loaded the questions. Where is my child? Where is my child? And things like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it indicates kind of like maybe in order to actually have your question answered, you have to go right into the cave, and people aren't quite willing to do so, but they're more willing to do so if it's a more question. Okay, interesting. But yeah, the first thing I do Hez becomes like up alongside me and sort of goes to step into the cave, I sort of like put a hand like on his shoulder and say, oh, be careful, friend, the water here is deep than it looks and very slippery.
And I think he just nods and just steps steps into the water, and as his foot goes into the water, you see the water like climb up his leg.
Mm-hmm.
Only it's the same way that like water falls from a ceiling filled with sediment and leaves a deposit to make like stalactites really slowly.
Mm-hmm.
Like he steps into the water, and his foot goes down, and the water goes up, and you can see like under the surface, like kind of like this thin layer of like rock.
Mm-hmm.
And then he steps in with the other foot, and he just like sinks. Like he walks down, and just like sinks until he's like completely below water, and just all rock.
I mean, I think it's only
and
like
then,
the stone itself is only like half a foot deep.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
Ash.
Cool.
And then there's this like slight quaking sound, and then the rock like splits open, and a gigantic, ferocious cave bear just like calmly steps up out of the hole in the ground.
Cool.
The water I'm fucking shapeshifting again, because I love
is...
being a druid.
Hey, just so while you're making this decision, the water is very hot. Like,
I know.
80, like ADC.
I'm a cave bear.
I'm gonna call you up there. You don't know. You
my
just
bear
found
comes
out.
From a my bear comes from a cave like this. In fact.
Sorry, I have a pet peeve. I have a pet peeve with players is when like the GM gives them new information, they go, "Oh, I know." No, you don't.
My character knows.
Cut it.
My character's been to this cave before, Emily.
Okay. So are you some kind of heat-resistant bear?
Mm-hmm.
Is that the
yeah, point? I'm like a bear that lives in these weird like thermal caves on this mountain.
Yeah, because like I can see like a
red panda.
No, what's the word? like a beaver or an otter type thing, like being resistant to the hot water. The bear, yeah, I can see maybe.
You'd have to be a very specific kind of bear, I think.
It's yeah, like, I think, just don't,
okay,
I don't
so
think
let,
that
let
if
me,
you
let,
just
me
say...
let me describe this to you. This bear is like more of a polar bear. Like, it is like a polar bear for like. Underground
heat.
Hot
a
springs.
Polar bear for heat.
A
thermal
polar
bear.
For underground hot
a thermal
springs.
Bear.
A thermal bear.
Right. I don't have any good words for this kind of bear, right? But like in the same way that like all bears can swim and some bears are made for like very cold water.
Yeah.
This is a bear that is made for like very hot water and like deep dark spaces underground, and it doesn't have very good eyesight.
It has
it's
like,
got, like
milky,
really good...
milky white eyes. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, and it's and it's like its fur is like. I think like completely white so that it like reflects heat away.
Yeah.
Yeah, right? And it's got this like huge lolling tongue from when it like pants to get rid of like to vent heat.
Yeah. So your abilities are probably like rend.
That sounds reasonable.
Detect scent and
like smell.
Take very hot baths.
Smell-o-vision.
Detect very hot baths.
No, take very hot baths.
Take hot baths. Mm-hmm. Can I write that down as like endure heat? Is that reasonable?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Cool. And now I'm gonna roll that move and see how many hole they get. And I'm probably gonna fail it and just get one, but I don't care. It's worth it.
You can turn into a big weird bear. You hold two.
Exactly. I get to hold two. I'm two hold worth of big weird bear.
Big weird bear.
And then I think Hezb Bear, like
Hezb Bear.
turns around and like gives this big like bearish grin, and his tongue like lolls out and he starts like panting, and then he just like steps forward and like nuzzles you with his big head, and like licks your face.
Yeah,
he's
yeah,
like
a whole bunch
like
of your face
big...
has no is like it's really like sparse hair on your face and like
yeah
and like
totally,
parts of
totally.
You. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's like a big fucking bear. Like, it's big bear.
Jellia looks to, Ajiti and, you know, kind of sardonically says, "It never ceases to be strange."
Yeah, I sort of nod and, like, kind of just pat the bear a little.
Yeah, and having heard
I think he invents some of these animals.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just like I just sort of look at you, I'm like, yeah, I've never seen that kind of bear before.
And having heard what Tialia said, I think I like nudge, like in the same way that you'd like fondly shoulder check someone, I do that but with my head, and you like
oh,
take
yeah.
like a sprawling step sideways.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This big heavy bear head. And then I just turn around and start like padding into the cave.
Cool.
On my big, I think they're slightly webbed bare feet.
Yeah, I like that. Alright, yes, let's do it.
Bear. I've got a beaver tail too.
We're here now, we
may as
navigating well
this cave
this path.
With its treacherous floor.
It's treacherous floor?
Slippery and hot.
Yeah.
I like slippery and hot.
Like, you can tell that, like, getting further into the cave with. Maze. Getting further into the cave without like falling and hurting yourself in the hot water and the hard stone is a challenge.
I'm a sauna bear. That's what this kind of bear is called. I'm gonna write it down.
Let me have a look here. I think I don't know if there's any like specific way to avoid this other than just be very careful.
Let me propose one. You get on the back of the bear.
I mean, yeah.
It's true.
That's a pretty good idea.
That is a way to avoid the danger.
I mean, we can't both get on the back of the bear. You'd have to make two trips.
You can't put two people and a horse on the back of a bear.
No, the horse can stay outside. Well, not outside, like in the mouth of the cave.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. In the mouth of the cave, yeah.
I mean,
I reckon a grizzly-sized bear is big enough for, like, a dwarf and an elf.
Yeah, because one is a dwarf.
Mm.
Yeah, one is a dwarf, and elves are, like, really, like, thin and, like,
wispy. Ultimately,
I think one is reasonable.
I could use my pole arm to kind of stabilize myself.
That's a very good point. You use, like, a 10-foot pole and probe in front of you. Some classic D&D shit.
It's probably wise for me to accept, some help from the spare, because I am not especially good at, you know, moving around of my own accord.
Cool.
Is it just me, or I feel like it seems like the laptop is freezing up, but everyone can still hear me okay?
Yeah,
well, I can't click on anything for the minute, so, and I can't see any of you.
That's
so
exciting.
I'll just wait and see what happens.
convenient. So I think then, Tialia, you need to mm-hmm. tell me, are you using strength or dexterity or constitution here?
Okay. I think it is, like, essentially what she's doing is using the pole arm to, you know, find a wall to, like, wedge herself in as she, like, walks and, like, you know, kind of press against. So she's kind of relying on, like, upper body strength to, like, hold herself in place. So even if she's, like, slipped feet-wise, I mean, how wide are these corridors? Like, I'm assuming that they are, like...
How tall is an elf is actually the important question here.
Yeah. I mean, tall, but not like super, super tall. It's a good point. We've got a giant grizzly bear, so it's not that tall.
I think I'm like 5 feet at the shoulder.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's probably
I'm about that size
then.
Of bear.
Like, I mean, even using the weapon,
because I think
for
it's probably like
a...
10 feet to 12 feet high.
Yeah, even using the weapon to stabilize, I think it's still dex.
Sure. Cool.
Let's see.
The mouse pad has stopped working.
Huh.
Wild.
Hmm.
But we can still see.
Yes, but I won't be able
to. Yay! A 7!
What about the touch screen?
Sorry?
What about the touch screen?
Good point. Maybe. Yeah.
Good job, now.
Yes.
Seven is the most fun on Defy Danger.
Seven is the most fun.
That's, it's the sweet
in
spot
any powered
in
by
everything.
Game, full
yes.
stop, because then you get the snowball.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a loud clatter as you fall to the ground, and the rumbling sound stops.
Ooh, that's not good. All right.
Okay.
You should probably also take some damage.
Okay.
You should probably take a d6.
Yep.
Oh no, d4. Yeah, sorry, d4. Makes sense.
D4?
It's like scrapes and bruises.
One! Yay!
Nice.
Yay.
And you got one armor.
Armor
does armor apply here?
Some of it's hot
it's...
water.
Oh yeah,
yeah,
the hot water.
I think that's
the
question.
I think the hot water is the one then. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hot water doesn't care how good your armor is. It'll fuck you up anyway.
Yeah.
Inconsiderate like that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You just ask a lobster.
Very true.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Poor fucking lobster spends like a millennia evolving to be real hard to kill, and then you put it in hot water.
Mm-hmm.
Rip.
Nope.
Cool.
Alright, so as you continue down the down this way, this smell of like chlorine in the like warm air starts to like it becomes muggy and chloriney, and you reach like the bit where you can see like all of the water is seeping out of the walls. and then there is a there's a drop, and it is a big, like you're peering down into the top of like a big bowl shaped cave. Do you have any light with you? Because
I got my sword.
Yeah, I mean,
my pole arm. Sorry.
Yeah. Because, yeah, it's a big open space down there. How far to
the... Oh, yeah, I don't have that.
I am going to spend... Wait, was that a source of light, Ash?
Yeah, source of light, yeah.
I am going to spend one hold to activate my smell-o-vision.
Mm.
And I do not need light, because I am a sauna bear adapted to such dark environments.
Yeah. The floor of this big bowl... is like obviously coated in this like chloriney, very alkaline, chlorine's an alkaline, isn't it? I think so.
I'm not a scientist.
Chloriney, alkaliney, water, that is like quite warm. And there's something in the middle of it that smells of scales and metal. And geraniums. I think you would recognize lightning, ozone.
Oh yeah,
mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah. I've been in storms before.
It is large.
Smelled the lightning.
It is a large creature sitting in the middle of this pond at the bottom of the bowl. Also, I think it's pretty obvious to like that to Mel with your glowing sword that there is a ramp down the like spiral down the bowl. It's covered in many small plants. I think they're flowers even. They're small vine-like things that have little light purple flowers. They remind you of lilacs. They remind you of lilacs, but
okay.
A bit, you know, obviously a bit hardier, thicker leaves and juicier stems.
Almost succulents?
Yeah.
Almost succulents, yeah.
This,
I snuffle at them. Do
this
they have
region...
purposes?
This region is familiar territory, and there's, you know, there have been elves here for a long time. It's a place we've fought over, that kind of thing. We almost certainly have stories about this place.
Do you want to spat some lore?
Yeah, I definitely do.
Yeah. From the smell, do these flowers have medicinal purposes?
If a person, I mean, like you could use them to create like that. If you were to squeeze them, they'd be drink, like the juice would be drinkable.
Mm.
So like it's not like medicinal for like dehydration, maybe.
Yep.
But like that's not the thing here that you're going to be worried about. 9. Okay, so.
But you need a bear nods, like nods.
Yeah, it would like these would make a very nice sweet tea.
I eat one. Just snaffle it up.
When it's a plant, it's very tart. But if you were to like squeeze it, it would make it a nice tea. No, not tart, astringent. Yeah.
So I think you have something interesting, but not...
Something interesting?
Like, not...
And this is about
not explained
this
out.
Cave? Or the area?
Yeah, I mean, about the cave of many questions, and the dangers and perils that might be within it, and that kind of thing.
Yeah, right.
The truth, which you cannot handle.
I can handle the truth.
You can't handle
that,
the truth.
That's the truth. There was the guy I got this sword from.
Something interesting, but not necessarily useful... the cave. I think they didn't always have this. The cave wasn't always here. I think the tale is that. That it is the body of. This is a body of like one of your ancestors, of like an ancestor elf.
Okay. Yeah, cool.
Who was, and the cave is like the wound of an Azamar,
mm-hmm.
who like pierced the body,
yeah,
like after it was dead.
Ah, okay, right.
Which is
cool.
A grave, like a it shows how like childish and like disrespectful,
petty,
and petty the Azamar are. Because I think the Azamar chased the ancestor elf until the ancestor elf like died of exhaustion because he had no horses.
Right. And then stabbed it.
And then stabbed it.
Just to say, I stabbed the elf. Yeah.
I feel like there's totally like a scornful ending to the story, and it's like, and then they like desecrated his body with a blade as though they were going to let his spirit out or like some similar fucking Azamar asshole.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Bullshit.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's the story here. This cave is representative of like the fact that Azamar think they're better than elves, even though they're clearly like morally inferior.
Yeah, right. Okay. I'm gonna start walking down the ramp.
Yep. It's slippery, but
I'm gonna find good footing.
I'm not trying to be especially stealthy.
Yeah.
I'm just walking down, leading the way. Ready for anything that might come my way, but not like walking down defensive pose, ready to stab something. Just confident, ready for whatever might happen. Fairly relaxed. I know where the thing is that's likely to attack us in this room. We don't actually know if it's dangerous.
Can you describe again, Ash? You said there is a medium, or there is a body, or
there is
a large creature.
Like
a large creature.
Like,
okay. Well, and
like
that's
not,
the thing
not
that you're saying.
Dragon's large, yeah. Like bigger than
yes.
that.
Yes. Okay. And that's the thing that you're referencing in the story about the ancestor elf? Or
no.
what is the body of the ancestor elf?
Oh, the whole
story?
The mountain,
I suppose.
The mountain is.
Yeah.
Got
so
it.
We're inside it. Yeah.
Got it. Cool.
I've got
I understand.
In me too.
I follow.
Yep.
Yeah, so I'm just like
smell
patting down after Tialia.
Whatever is in the middle is like breathing and deeply and exhaling slowly. It's doing the same thing you're doing. It's smelling the air. You can like taste its breath on the breeze. Its breath is almost mentholy. It's got that same ring of ozone about it as well.
Greetings, cousin.
From the depths, there are words, but do any of you speak fire?
I can understand any animal akin to my land or akin to one whose essence I have studied, and snakes are creatures of the forest.
Dragons are.
I wasn't sure how sneaky it was. Like,
yeah, it's This is.
I think there are elves who can, and I recognize it, but I do not speak. I'm not a scholar.
I think
it's
so,
like
yeah.
the elders and you know that kind of thing.
What color is the light of your sword of your blade?
It glows that yellowy like sunlight kind of.
Yeah.
Light.
So the yellowy sunlight illuminates the like iridescent scales, the iridescent amber scales of this like gigantic serpentine creature.
It's even
curled.
Bigger than a giant centipede.
It's a lot bigger than a giant centipede. This yeah, it's curled gracefully into like a pile in the middle of the thing, but like so that as much water is like lapped over it as possible, and I think as you like pass the light over it, its giant eyes like open with like the like three different layers of lids like peeling back to reveal
membranes.
Yeah, to reveal these big deep emeralds with like infinitely black pupils slitting down them in two directions, making like a cross that like opens and closes as it adjusts to the light of your sword.
Yeah. Guardian. Sorry, you say.
I have an action that I'd kind of like to start because I think it might take a little while and I can do it in the background.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to use my move, the move that I have, which is Divine Guidance. When you petition your deity according to the precept of your religion, you're granted some useful knowledge or boon related to your deity's domain. Mm-hmm. GM will tell you what.
What's the precept again?
My precept is gaining secrets.
Are you asking for the ability to understand the language of fire?
I mean, that would be great. Yeah. It says it's like you're granted some useful knowledge or boon dependent on what my deity feels. But yeah,
I feel like that's appropriate.
Yeah, I'm asking for like help in gaining the secrets that this thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Guards. And my domain is knowledge and hidden things. So I feel like it's very.
Yeah, I think that's. So yeah. And I think like one of the things that Shana does is like allow understanding of languages and cycle, mm-hmm. right? Like Shana allows you to see through ciphers as well.
Yeah, cool. That's awesome. It's very useful for spies to just know languages, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. But yeah, this will take some time. You have to like,
mm-hmm.
because the point is you have to like cleanse your tongue or cleanse your ears of the mm-hmm. language you know so that you can take on this other language mm-hmm. in the meantime.
Mm-hmm.
So
I think I think the way that I'm doing that actually is that I take the sphere, the star sphere out of the pouch at my belt, mm-hmm. And sort of like kind of meditate while staring into it and try to like
put it in your mouth.
Clear.
Because then it'll ring through. I was wondering if you're going to put it in your mouth so then the vibrations go through your head to your ears. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe. Do you say it does it? Oh yeah, you said it emits some kind of vibration. Is that?
It hums with this. It hums. With the like the song of the stars. It buzzes with the energy
the
of the galaxy
are
within
like,
it.
The stars are cousins to fire.
Yeah. All right. I mean, I thought it was too big to put in my mouth. But
no, it's a little.
It's small. Small. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then I just Then I'll just sort of hold it there and try and tune out the sound of everyone talking, basically.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cool. I think the bear is no longer talking. Is just like, just continuing to like snuffle and smell and like get a picture of like what is going on here.
Yeah.
And like letting Tialia do all the talking.
Mm-hmm.
Which probably isn't going to achieve anything. But
his Hez doesn't have any questions.
Yeah. Yeah. So Tialia will say, Guardian, we come with questions. I am Tialia of the old people of the mountains. Do you guard this place? How may we pass?
Before it does a thing, may I roll a discern realities?
Yes.
Oh, heck yeah.
Nice.
Yes.
Heck yeah. All right. Let me see. let me have a think about what questions I like.
Please explain.
I'm not sure what you're laughing about, everyone. Are you okay there, Emily McCullough?
I like the idea that this is what happens to Hez's voice after he like turns back out of animal form. Like he just gets this like his voice just didn't work right for a while.
He becomes a trap
I think that's totally true, but I think his voice just comes out sounding like really like ragged and just awful and like fucked up.
Not
so more Tom Waits rather than Paul.
Tom Waits, because he's forgotten how to make human vocal cords work exactly.
Yeah.
All right, my questions are: I'm gonna start with the ones I'm sure of. What here is useful or valuable to me?
I mean, this thing is literally celestial.
Hmm.
Right,
oh,
it is among the choir of it is a representative a representative of... Do we reckon it's ER, Emily, or is it Nademu?
I feel like it seems like it would be Nademu.
Yeah.
No, because that wouldn't... If it's about, like, secrets and answers and truth and things, I don't know that it... Oh, it could be a Nademu thing.
No, but the point is, like... Yeah, it's Nademu. Yeah, that adds up to me.
Yeah, it could be.
So,
because specifically, Ash, it's about not knowing.
I'm gonna point out, the wording of the question is useful or valuable to me.
Yeah.
And I have no questions that need answering, and I don't give a shit about its answers.
Okay.
Like, that is not useful or valuable to me, because it's not... It's, like, I'm here to protect my friends. Like,
yeah,
in that
right. You're here to protect your friends. Right.
Yeah, that's
cool.
What I give a shit about.
Can you give me some other questions just so I can kind of like...
To form the context? Yeah,
yeah.
Absolutely. Then also, what here is not what it appears to be.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
And I haven't decided on my last question yet, because I think it'll depend a little on...
Yeah, can I say that, like, it's a celestial, what here is not what it appears to be? It is literally... So in the splintering will,
yeah.
the technical term would be angel.
Yeah, right. Like,
in that it is an immortal spirit that is below the wardens but above mortals. It is, yeah.
So we can't kill it.
You can kill these things, they just don't die, right? Like, they don't
expire
naturally. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so it's like it's an abomination.
I mean,
it's a thing that defies the flow of all things returning to death and becoming
according
incorporated.
To
like,
you,
it is a thing. Yeah, right, like within my context and within like within like the kind of Horu model of the world, like it is a bad thing.
I don't know. I don't,
should work.
I don't think that would
well,
be strictly
no, because...
true, because then Horu would defy those rules. So
yeah, I think the point is that like mortal things and immortal and like so like elves defy it despite the fact that they shouldn't, right? In this...
Right, whereas this thing is not meant to end.
It's not meant to, yeah.
It's like water or rock. Yeah, okay, cool. Yep, that makes sense. What here is useful or valuable to protecting me friends? Me frienders, me frienderoos.
I think if it's to do with protecting your friends, the water is very important to the creature.
It likes the water.
It likes the water a lot.
Yep. Excellent. I have a plan.
Also in the context of like protecting my friends, what should I be on the lookout for? Like what's the danger sign here? Everything's about to go to shit.
This thing is all like mark one annoyed. Right, it is.
Okay, so we've...
Talia steps forward, like, presenting
herself. We're already, we're already at, like, DEFCON 5. Okay,
The words coming out of Talia's mouth are annoying it and making it
cool.
More likely to fucking eat her.
Poor Talia.
Cool.
You hear, like a clicking... noise coming from its throat.
Cool. So, is the water deeper in, like, I'm picturing this hollow as being kind of like semi-flooded, so we're all like up to our...
It's a bowl, remember. So it's deepest where it is.
Oh yeah, cool. Great. Okay, in that case, I like, grab, in my mouth... Tialia's, like, the back of Tialia's clothes. I'm, like, give, like, a tug as if to say, like, come back here, and then indicate with my head and, like, grunt softly that I want a GD, like, off me.
I'm already
you're already off? Oh, good,
okay.
Good.
I'm backed up a little way, like,
your friend is paying attention. Okay, Ash, so, like, just to be totally sure, right? Like, it is apparent to me that this situation is, like, imminently critical.
Yeah, I'm already, like, I have not entered the immediate danger zone. I have stayed up the ramp, not gone down, just to clarify.
Yeah.
Cool.
If she keeps talking, she will get eaten.
Yeah, so, like when Hesp tugs on her clothes, she's confused, but she knows Hesp generally knows what he's doing, so she like kind of shuts up and steps back, not like leaving the area completely, but like steps back to see what Hesp is gonna do or what Hesp wants or whatever.
Yeah, and so I think I'm gonna spend my last hold to endure heat, so that I like don't mind the temperature in here. Just mm-hmm. just cause.
Yep.
That God, that'd be a useful power to have in real life, huh?
This time.
And I shed the shape of the sauna bear. I think the sauna bear, like the texture of its skin, like fades from white to like stone marble, and then goes into like sediment rich liquid and just like washes off, and then it's just like has slightly damp.
Yeah, cool.
And he just like grabs Talia by the scruff of the neck, right? Like the proverbial scruff of the neck, and he's like, like smacks you on the back, and then turns around and then like tugs you back, and I think has grabbed a GD with the other hand and is just like very like gently and cautiously like backing everyone back and looking at the serpent to see if this has made a difference and yes. whether or not like this is the point at which we need to escalate into violence or if we can just like back out now, like where are we on that nice edge?
Like dilates and constricts, focusing on you. The other is closed as it like peers up from at you. And I think, and then like once you like get off the ramp and back into the like the tunnel, you hear the like click 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 of the three eyelids closing.
Yep. Okay. And then I'm gonna like walk us back like a couple more steps.
I think we upset it.
Yes. I think we need to use the right words.
You spoke to it in mortal words. It was, and I hold up, you were, and I hold up my, like, and just, like, don't finish the sentence.
It doesn't understand you, so it's,
it seems
like a waste of time.
I don't think it's a matter of don't understand, I think it's a matter of offense.
Should we say nothing at all? Do we even need to speak to it? Can we simply pass it?
I'm assuming by this point, because I'm speaking, that I have taken the thing out of my mouth, so maybe
yep.
I've finished what
I
was doing?
I think you've finished your ritual. Yeah. Yeah.
How do I feel?
People's words, you're understanding, but only as if they were garbled in water or mud.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's as if they're why are they talking with their mouths half closed as if they want to keep the truth within them, right? Like
mm-hmm.
that
yeah.
everything sounds like this now. Like they're like
okay.
like they're not really trying to talk properly. Why you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think Hesp has turned and is just like talking to Talia,
mm-hmm.
and is like
yep.
and like is not really focusing on AGD, and if she slips away to go and talk to the
mm-hmm.
weird snake is not necessarily gonna notice right away. He's just looking at Talia and is like, there is no past, it is the thing that answers questions. We leave questions and come back to get answers. You don't speak to the celestial.
I think that's
carry paper.
I think that's
exactly right.
Like the minute where you hear me speaking. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. And,
so,
and
yeah,
I'm in the middle of saying, and I'm in the middle of saying, like, take your papers and stick your questions up on them. Like,
yeah.
And I don't understand because I think I'm probably illiterate. I'm just like, do the writing thing, and we'll fucking come back tomorrow, and you'll have your stupid answers, and then yeah, we hear like,
or whatever.
Weird fire noises we hear.
Yeah. Okay.
So do you speak in like fire to them, or do you go down and like do your?
I'm gonna go down and speak, and I'm gonna say, what did the gnomes refer to it as? Did they just say
the
serpent? They didn't give it any other name.
I think it was just a serpent.
Okay.
Yeah, I think they said the serpent. Yeah.
Okay. I'll give it some kind of honorific, like, you know, great one or something suitably.
Yeah, yeah.
Sort of important.
I mean, like, angel is a, it, like, isn't usually.
Yeah, okay.
Like, just is not, fine. Like, it, like, is an elevated term.
Cool. Well, okay, I'll address it as angel then and say, may I speak plainly with you?
Never before have you so hated your tongue and lips and teeth, these barriers that get in the way of truth and meaning getting, like, coming from your, like, your chest.
So, yeah, that's interesting, because I think that would feel like, if that's kind of, do you feel like that is,
if you're speaking
an almost
fire,
sort of magical understanding?
Yeah.
Okay, because, yeah, because that's very counter to what I would do, like, how I would normally feel.
Yeah, no, speaking fire is like this.
Okay,
like,
cool.
Like, to do so with like, a person's mouth is, you know, is like this. That is the experience of it.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. And it, like, its mouth and teeth and tongue slide and clack and crackle against each other. And, like, yeah, it sounds like there is just, and then it exhales and there's, like, a roar. And it sounds to the others like there's a bellows and a campfire below.
Mm-hmm.
But you understand its words. And
okay.
It just replies with a, I am listening. What is your question? Do you want to know the answer? May I speak plainly? Is not a very good question.
So I think that, yeah, there's a thing where I sort of, like, open my mouth to answer, realize what I'm about to say is a lie, decide better, and instead I say, my friend who cannot speak correctly would ask a question, and I would like to hear that answer. May I translate? Or actually, no, I say, I will translate, and then I wait.
Yeah.
Like, I don't propose it as a question. I say,
yeah.
I will translate, and I wait to see whether there's any kind of, like, adverse reaction, and if not, then I'll, like, call out to Tialia.
I think it says, there may be a cost, but I will not know until the question is asked.
I say, it will be a cost to Tialia, or to me.
Tialia asks the question.
Okay. And then I, yeah, turn around and like, sort of call up, and I'm like, Tialia, I think I've worked something out. What do you want to ask? I can translate for you.
Tialia considers, right, looks very thoughtful. How do I return my people to the cycle?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I can convey that, and I say, Tiali would like to know, how can she return her people to the cycle?
I think at this point, Em, I'd like you to roll Defy
sure.
Danger for the sheer, like, for the words coming out of your mouth, right? Like,
yeah, yeah, like, it's dangerous.
Constitution to not burn up from the inside.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
yeah,
absolutely.
There's something here. Is it charisma? Is it constitution? I don't know. Literally, your voice could take your teeth out of your mouth right now.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to do that. It's because I'm using the touchscreen. I mean, I'd love it to be wisdom, but, you know.
Sure, that's
probably
fine, I'll allow it. To, like,
yeah?
to control yourself, right? Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm.
And I feel, I would argue that I'm, like, like fictionally positioned well for this, because I've spent, you know, my whole life as a servant of Shan, learning to control the truth.
Yeah.
And like
totally. Yeah.
And Ash, as this is going on, Hesba's like moved forward and is just like perching right on the lip of the like ramp, like up the top, just like watching over this, and like the like slow calcification is just like creeping up his legs,
mm-hmm.
as he just like stands totally ready to like take action if this all were to go suddenly precipitously wrong.
But it's okay, don't worry, the situation the bad thing does not come to bear.
Yes, which is very good. I am very glad to hear
it. You don't get it. It doesn't come
yes,
to bear.
I'm not becoming a bear.
Sorry.
Y'all are trying so hard and it's just not working.
Sorry.
Emily,
I'm
you
sorry,
ask
I'm
this
dad.
Question and
okay.
and you succeed.
Yeah. I get an 11. Yes.
Like
is
words of flame spill forth from your lips. They lick around your teeth and roll over your tongue. Your mouth is full and warm with truth. The dragon opens both eyes, rolls its head, its tendrilled chin like lolling in the water. And it says to you, Tialia, an elf who wishes for elves to be not what elves are, should take babes from their mothers and give them away. The children should go unheard when they cry out for their father's embrace.
Mm-hmm.
You're muted, Tialia.
That's said to Ajiti in fire, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I think it specifically is like it says like children will not learn to walk into their father's embrace, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think yeah. There's this moment where like I think about it. I think about how like no one else is understanding this. I think about how I could just like say whatever I want, you know, as a translation.
Yeah.
Then I think about, you know, I'm in the presence of a creature that values truth. Would it just like kill me for doing that? But then the more important thing is that I know that Shan has marked you for
mm-hmm.
some significant purpose, and this aim may well be it.
Mm-hmm.
So, there's like a pause of silence that seems sort of unnecessarily long. But then I translate it back to you word for word.
Mm, okay. Charlie kind of looks distant and says, please, thank you for me. Is there a price I need to pay?
I say, Talia thanks you and asks if there is a cost.
Hesb is a rock at this point.
Like, for real?
Also,
is that good? Like, is that a thing that Hez does?
Yeah, I'm like in the like shape-shifting cocoon.
Oh.
And like ready on like a split second's notice to like erupt.
Right. Sorry. Yes. Okay.
And
yeah.
Do a cool shape-shifting shenanigan.
Can you please roll me a Defy Danger with Wisdom, please, Tialia?
Oh no, that's my worst stat.
I help you by becoming the crayfish of wisdom and springing down.
Actually, that's a good point. Emily can aid here.
Yeah, I would love to.
If you want to.
Okay.
If it's helpful, we'll see.
I cannot believe the crayfish of wisdom's help has been rejected in this match.
Unbelievable.
Can someone please tweet that?
Andrew will be outraged by this insult.
So does the aid roll go first?
No, it goes after.
Okay.
Because it might not be needed.
Then. It's needed.
Okay. Is it going to help?
Yeah, oh, yeah, it's like level 6.
Right? It'll push us over the up. It'll push us up the edge.
So it's this plus 1. Okay. All right. So I get
a
7.
No.
No, I get a 7 because right. I didn't
cool.
add the 1 for Abond.
So that's right. Sevens all round, which means
yeah.
It's yeah. Plus,
so
plus 1, but M is exposed to the cost.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This means you're also on the hook for payment. You fool.
It's fine.
I think I have an answer for this one, which is, Tialia's assistant. It says Tialia's assistant. I have looked. I can see from her face that the cost will be paid. And I can see, as you aid her, you will help her pay the cost. And I think that's all it says.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes sense to me. I'm like, mm-hmm. It seems like the cost is not going to be, you know, you have to pay me for this information, but
it's
more
the answer.
You have to pay for like the horrible answer
yeah.
that you got, and if you're going to act on it, it's going to suck. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that well, mm-hmm. like it's pretty obvious that like yeah, like. You are going to act on it.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
this
if,
is now
if you,
the...
If you weren't, then it would have demanded another payment.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's. I mean, it's like whole thing of like, by giving an answer, it has made that possible future the one that is going to happen, right?
Happen,
like,
yeah.
It,
yeah, yeah,
it
yeah.
has narrowed down the various potentials.
Truth isn't
yeah.
real. It picked the truth it liked.
Mm.
Yeah, cool.
I think...
Okay.
What
I kind
deck?
Of want to finish there.
Yeah,
yeah.
I mean that's perfect.
Mm.
Is that cool?
We did the thing.
Is everyone cool?
Yeah.
Good
yeah.
job, fam.
It was very cool.
Yep, I love it.
Cool.
And it's very good. Yeah, spot to finish on.
I love being a druid. Being a druid is my favorite.
Yeah. Cool. I liked your weird bear. At the start, I was like, what? And then I was like, this is cool.
I was gonna if it had been a dick, I was gonna turn into a giant mountain eagle and pick up its head and
fucking
pull its
eagles.
Head up out of the water so that it
was
dry
cool.
and uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And also so that it could then have been stabbed in the
stabby,
face.
Stabby, stabby. Yeah, but how will that go last time?
Yeah. No, that was...
I mean, look, we got there eventually. Last
yeah.
time you only took like 7 damage, I healed it immediately after, I still
Ooh.
Got another use of poultices.
Yeah. No,
we would have been
fine. Yeah.
It's true.
It would have maybe fucking killed you, but who knows.
Do we
want
to do
our XP questions quickly?
Yeah.
XP.
Yeah.
So, yeah, because we have, I can't remember how this goes. Do we have group questions?
Yeah.
We
have to.
So, alignment,
yeah,
alignment first.
Alignment, yeah.
Alignment, then bond, then questions.
Then bonds,
yeah.
Questions. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm.
So, who wants to start?
I'm happy to start.
Cool.
I don't know if it was explicit enough. I don't think it was. I think I could kind of argue that in like the way that I refused to help Lily after she kind of at least to my mind proved herself like weak and you know lacking in willpower would be like harming another to prove the superiority of your church or god, but I'm not sure that that's entirely
what
applicable. Sorry, yeah,
does that count?
I don't know. I don't know that I made that clear enough, so.
Yeah. I mean, it was
like
harming by refusing to help.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
Like, that's inaction rather than action. Mm-hmm. So I don't mm-hmm. think it counts. So that's,
yep.
that's fine.
So not that one. And then is it...
Did you resolve any bonds?
Resolve any bonds? Oh, no. I acted on some bonds, but I don't think I have helped Tialia fulfill her destiny. There is still more destiny.
I feel like right, it's progressed.
Yeah,
which is the thing. Like resolved. Resolved is really muddy mm-hmm. wording in Dungeon World, but like progressed mm-hmm. is much more what it means. I've seen it read to mean.
Yep.
I think like you could totally argue for like scratch that and write like a specific
true.
Bond
yep.
about like you now know what the destiny is, and so
yeah.
now it's like Tialia and I must take lead the children of the elves into a bright
mm-hmm.
new future.
Yeah.
Like, fuck it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like that. All right. So I think that's it for me.
Cool. Do you want to go
now? Yeah.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah,
thanks. So.
The bond.
Yeah. So I'll start alignment. Yeah, I mean, I think I did get mine, which was for neutral is to defeat a worthy foe,
mm-hmm.
which I feel like the moth was a pretty decent one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
because
I mean,
they
that was a pretty epic battle.
Yeah, exactly right. And it could have gone really bad.
Yeah.
And you know, if my character were not like a capital letter adventurer, you know, like it would have been,
you'd be dead.
They would have avoided it rather than getting into that situation.
Oh, true. That makes sense.
So yeah, so 1 XP is it for that? Cool. And bonds. I feel like definitely the bond with Hesp has changed, because now I'm like Tialia is on a different path.
Hesb's shape-shifting disturbs and confuses
me. I mean, yes.
Legit.
I wish he would do it less often.
Yeah. I mean, yes. Let's just go with that.
What was the bond? I've totally forgotten.
It was
forgotten.
A sworn to protect, and the reasoning was because I was going to try to use you to like become legitimately immortal.
Oh yeah, right.
But now
I've,
you know,
turned
like,
away from that path.
Exactly. Yeah.
I will show you to embrace mortality, my friend.
I think it's probably now something like I have things. There are things that I can learn from Heads.
Yeah, I can teach you how to die. I know
yeah.
how to do that. Done it twice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. Totally. And so for Agiti, it was Agiti owes me.
So you
life.
You can only resolve.
Oh, you can
one
only
bond.
Do one. Cool. Okay, no worries.
You pick one.
Yep.
Sweet.
Cool.
And how much XP do you need to level up?
Seven.
Dang.
Plus
oh.
current level, I think.
Yep.
Okay. Cool.
I did not do my alignment thing.
Okay.
I did not destroy a symbol of civilization. I should have just ripped down all those questions and had a big tent.
Oh, totally, legit. Or alternatively, like, killed the dragon.
I mean, that would have been tricky.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna say the spirits spoke to me of a great danger that follows Tialia. It's like this fucking, like, destiny that this, like, bad snake has placed upon her.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's, in fact, actually, no, I belay that. It's the bad snake. I don't like the snake. I think the snake is bad.
Yep.
Yeah, sure. Because
like here's the thing, the great secret of nature is that like truth and lies are like fucking like it's all bullshit, right? Like the arbitrary it's distinction, bullshit. Like those things are knowledge, and knowledge comes about because mortal creatures like live and think it, and that is all just temporary. Like none of it is objectively real. It's all just like a passing shadow on a cave wall.
Yeah.
And so, like, that fucking puffed up snake with its bullshit nonsense, like, fuck off. We're all gonna die. It's gonna die.
Great.
It's gonna die one day, too, right? Like, even the universe will not live forever.
That's so strange.
Immortal.
Ooh,
immortal, quote unquote. Yeah.
Yeah, fuck off.
Cool.
Well then, as a group, did we learn something new and important about the world?
Yes.
It's
session one. It's session one, so like always.
Yeah.
We didn't have a world when we started.
Yeah.
True. true.
And we had such a cool world by the end of it.
Exactly. I want to see more of it, dang it. Oh, Ash, every time you run a game, I want to find out more.
Yeah. Did we overcome a notable monster or enemy?
Yeah, I think that that butterfly was definitely that.
Well, and like we overcame the snake.
And we overcame
the
snake.
Not through violence, but we did overcome it.
True. Did we loot a memorable treasure?
I mean, I actually would argue that in the context of like the cave of like questions, like getting an answer
is
a valid treasure. Like,
yep,
is a sick loot.
Yeah, definitely. Cool. Well, then.
Do we get one XP for each of those?
Yeah, for each of those. Yeah. So
I'm on six XP.
I leveled up.
Yeah, well done.
Enough loot.
We need that.
I should have just turned into an eagle and fought that fucking snake.
Sweet.
Would have done it too if we hadn't been running out of time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when I realized like the time was like ticking down, I was like, what is a worthy conclusion for the game? I was like, I could ask is any number of questions, but I was like, no, I've got to like
that was a good one.
Bring the circle
back around.
Yeah, that was nice.
I felt like in the end we were not as rat queens as perhaps we initially intended.
I know.
But I think we made a cooler thing.
Yeah. No, I think what we did was really cool.
Mm-hmm.
And very like it was very much me running Dungeon World and also this group, right? It was
very typical of all of us.
Yeah.
Cool.
So,
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What does that involve? I'm very curious. I know it's not necessarily safe, but yeah.
Sorry?
Oh, like what? I'm curious, like what the characteristics of the group are, like in terms of like.
Yeah, right.
But also, like I know it's like difficult to actually put into words that kind of thing. So it's just a rhetorical question.
Yeah, we do a lot of like
M is thoughtful and unexpected.
Sweet.
In the best possible way, like.
Cool.
And makes characters that are like really, really like surprising and interesting in ways you don't expect.
Sweet. Thank you.
I just
That's
make
really
things
nice.
Spooky and weird.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Like
mm-hmm.
I just fucking.
It's
I
also
that.
Like you also like rock out like sudden mystic wisdom, like just mm-hmm. like it's that.
And you're very you give a lot of like fodder for like the world and the narrative and things. You're sort of constantly like injecting information into.
Yeah,
putting my degree in English and anthropology to good use.
Exactly.
I mean, Andrew described our group, like our like local culture, as being very much like very context heavy. We establish a lot of context.
Yes, I think that's very true.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
yeah, and then like Ash is also very spooky and weird,
mm-hmm.
like me, but also
mm-hmm.
very feelsy and also very unexpected in the same way in like the same way that M is, but from a
mm-hmm.
GM like level rather than.
Mm.
a this
mm-hmm.
level.
Yeah.
And Mel does really good, like really like unexpected like emotional through lines.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
Like
absolutely.
small things
happen. That's
what
happen. I want to do. Cool.
Mm.
Small things happen and you don't realize in the moment how much weight they're going to have.
Mm.
And like
mm-hmm.
it sneaks up on you how like weighty and significant and like emotional it is going to be.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
then it just like devastatingly is dropped in a really matter-of-fact way
mm-hmm.
and you're just
like
wow.
Exactly. Oh my god, my feelings. Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Mission accomplished. Thank you, Luke. That's very sweet.
Shall we do some shout-outs?
Yeah, let's.
Yeah, let's do it.
Oh
god. You can start then, Luke.
Hello, I am Luke. When I am not shouting out. when I'm not rolling to gaze into the abyss, I am a professional GM for children by day and then by night. I write a bunch of role-playing games, and I play on games like this. I have a bunch of games in the work at the moment, which you can find on my Patreon and like help playtest and get access to there. And I also write games that some of which are finished, some of which other people played this morning, and you can buy them at my itch.io.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Melody?
Hello, I'm Melody. I'm like a writer, historian, soon to be Dr. Watson.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I was gonna mention it if you didn't.
I do a lot of role-playing game stuff. Someone should pay me to do it so I actually have time to work on games.
I would pay you if I could.
I know, you're all amazing.
I will give you money on Patreon. You just need to set it up.
Yeah, but anyway. follow me on Twitter at MagicSpaceGirl, or check out my website where there's links to pretty much all the stuff I've written, which is mostly just available for free. At
melodynova.wordpress.com.
Emily.
Hi, I'm Emily. How am I going?
It's been a long day.
It has. It's been great. It's been
You're
a great
still
day.
Awake.
I am, and I've had a fantastic time. I've had a really, really good time today.
Achievement so. Unlocked.
Yes. I am a filmmaker and an artist, and I do this a bunch, and mostly on this channel. And you can follow me on Twitter at BlackWolfSays, or I am also on Tumblr and on YouTube at BlackWolfHoliday. Thank you very much for
also does wonderful commissions of both
I
characters
do.
And real people. And if
I
you
do.
Would like one of those, you should find the link
yes.
on her Twitter and talk
yes.
to her about doing that.
Yes, that also. Yes, if you want portraits of your role-playing game characters or your loved ones or both, if those things intersect,
yes.
I can help you with that.
What were you saying?
I need to get cashed up so I can commission you.
I think I was saying that I had a really good time with this and it was really fun to play with all of you, and also again thank you to Elf and to Andrew for joining us this morning, and to everyone in the chat for being so lovely and like cheerful and nice and good today. It's been a really, really nice, busy, happy chat.
Yeah, it's been good.
It's awesome people in chat.
Yeah.
So also happy birthday again, Ash.
Yeah.
Yes.
Happy birthday. Such a good
it's been
yes.
real good. I'm gonna jump over to just me. Hello.
Mm-hmm.
It's been 13 hours. It's been real fun. We played two role-playing games and a shit ton of Minecraft. And y'all have been real nice. I have the best chat. Y'all are real good. I'm so lucky to have such a great chat. It's been a great birthday. This has been really, really fun. If you don't already follow me, hit the follow button here, or you can follow me on all of the things: Twitter, Twitch, YouTube, Instagram, Mastodon, Tumblr, or my blog. So acegiak, A-C-E-G-I-A-K, and acegiak.net is my blog. And if you want to, you can hit subscribe. I'm working on making it so that people who subscribe to the Twitch channel get access to the games I write for free. That's a thing I'm working on. And we will be back on Sunday, because Saturday I'm having a party in the real world. We're going to the zoo. Maybe I should stream the zoo. I shouldn't stream
yes.
the zoo.
Yes.
Yes.
That's pretty cool.
Yes. Especially because it's a game. It's going to be a game.
But it's like many hours, and I don't know that I could possibly have enough battery for that.
True.
Oh, shit. Remind me, while y'all are at the zoo, to find that micro-RPG someone wrote about watching a flock of birds. Because
yes.
I reckon that would be a really cool thing to play while at the zoo. I reckon that would be dope as hell.
I mean, we're going
to we won't be able to
anyway,
stream the whole of Zoo Bingo then, but maybe
well,
you
might,
can
we
do
might
a little
stream some of it. We
yeah.
might stream some of it. So yeah, we'll be back on Sunday at least, if we don't stream the zoo on Saturday. Until then, thank you so much for coming and joining me on my birthday.
Mm-hmm.
It's been the best
birthday.
Time, and I've had such a nice day. But
yeah.
it is bedtime, so
yeah.
wherever you are, I hope the rest of your day is nice, and if it's bedtime where you are, I hope you sleep well. Until next time, I'll catch you later. Bye!
Bye!